Hello everyone, welcome back. So in this lecture we are going to study about the free vibration with viscous damping. So here we consider a system which is attached to this base with the help of K and C. This is damper and this is spring and this is mass M, right? And this is the equilibrium position of this mass under the influence of gravitational force and force exerted by these components. Now, if we displace its equilibrium with the help of x, which is displacement in the downward direction. So, if this is the direction of x, then this is the direction of x dot and x double dot, right? And at this position, it will experience a force exerted by spring as well as force exerted by damper. And as we studied, the damping force is proportional to the velocity and it's acting in the opposite direction of the velocity. So if we draw the free body diagram of this mass M, so that will be, this is mass M, and this will experience a force in this direction because of this spring, that would be Kx, and the force because of this damper, that force would be Cx dot, right? And if this is the direction of x double dot, then there would be a inertia force in the opposite direction of the direction of x double dot, and that would be here through its Cg. So this is m x double dot. Now if we use the force equilibrium approach and write the equation of motion for this mass, then that would be m x double dot is equal to minus kx minus c x dot, and this would be m x double dot plus c x dot plus kx is equal to zero. So this is our governing equation. Now after the development of governing equation, next step is to develop the solution for this governing equation, and we can assume the solution of this equation in the form of the solution is xt equals to a e raised to power st. So we assume this solution in this form. Now if this is the solution, then we can say that this solution must satisfy the governing equation. So before putting this x into this equation, we'll find out the x dot and x double dot. So first differentiation of this dxt over dt, which is x dot t, is equal to as e raised to power st, and x double dot d square xt over dt square x double dot of t, which is equal to as square e st. Now we are having the value of xt, and this is x dot and x double dot t. So if we put these three value in the governing equation, then we'll have, this is m, and at the place of x double dot, this is a s square e raised to power st. At the place of x dot, we'll put this value, this is a s e raised to power st, plus k at the place of x, this is a e raised to power st is equal to zero. So if we simplify this equation, so this will be a and e raised to power st will get cancelled out, right? So this becomes, from here this equation becomes m s square plus c s plus k equals to zero. So from here, this is the quadratic equation in S, and this will have two roots of S. So we'll find out the value of S1 and 2, and that would be minus C plus minus C square minus 4 MK over 2M. or we can write C by 2m plus minus C by 2m whole square minus k by m. So these are the two roots S1 and S2. Here S1 is, so we can write S1 is minus C by 2m plus C by 2m whole square minus k by m, and value of S2 is minus C by 2m minus C by 2m square minus k by m. So now there are two values of S, so we can say, and both of the value will satisfy this equation. So these both of the value of S will satisfy this equation. So we can write the general solution of this equation as xt is equal to a1 e raised power s1t plus a2 e raised power s2t. And if we replace the value of s1 and s2, then we'll have xt is equal to a1 e raised to power minus c by 2m plus c by 2m square minus k by m multiplied by t plus a2 e raised to power minus c by 2m minus square root of c by 2m whole square minus k by m and multiplied by t. So this is the complete solution of this equation, right? So here constants a1 and a2, so these are two constants, and these constants a1 and a2 are to be determined using initial conditions. And initial conditions are the value of displacement and value of velocity at t is equal to zero time, or we can say how we start the vibration. So vibration can be started using these two initial conditions. So if this is the mass, m, and to start with the vibration, we can give the x at t is equal to zero time, that is denoted by x naught, and we can give the velocity, which is x dot at t is equal to zero time, which is denoted by x naught dot. So to start with the vibration, we can give the displacement alone, so vibration will be started, and we also can give the displacement and velocity at t is equal to zero time, so we can give the both, so vibration will get started, or we can give the velocity alone to start with the vibration. So these are the initial conditions. So displacement and velocity at t is equal to zero time. So using these initial condition, we can find out the value of a1 and a2. So here this is the complete solution of this governing equation. That governing equation was mx dot cx dot plus kx is equal to zero. A1 and A2 can be find out using these initial conditions. So in the next lecture, we'll talk about the critical damping constant and damping ratio. Then we'll study the overdamped vibration, critical damped, and underdamped vibration. So thank you.